Hi there.
In this video, we'll be discussing some exporting and printing tips in InDesign, so let's get started. In order to understand printing, you need to understand the difference between the RGB and CMYK colors. RGB refers to the primary colors of light, red, green, and blue that are used in monitors, television screens, digital cameras, and scanners, whereas CMYK refers to the primary colors of pigment, cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. These are the inks used on the press in four-color process printing, commonly referred to as full-color printing or four-color printing. The combination of RGB lights creates white, while the combination of CMYK inks creates black. Therefore, it is physically impossible for the printing press to exactly reproduce colors as we see them on our monitors. To make you understand the separation process of the CMYK colors, let's go to Window and then Output and select Separation Process option. Everything you see on the artboard is made up of these four colors. The K of CMYK actually stands for key, as it's a key color or key plate. The colors you see on the screen are in the RGB mode, but when they're printed, they need to be converted to CMYK. Here, if I remove the rest of the colors and make it a grayscale image, it is going to look much like this, which means the highlights, the midtones, the shadows are all achieved using different tones of black. When I select just the yellow color, this image is going to look like this. Magenta covers quite a lot in this image. As you can see, it brings about a lot of details in the image, and so does cyan. Particularly the sky and the shadows are covered pretty well using cyan. Now, on top of cyan, when the printer adds magenta, it will start to look something like this. You can find the different colors forming of the mountain, the sky, and the ground as well, but the overall image still looks very dull. Add yellow and it will enhance the image a little further, but doesn't complete the image because the key color is still missing. You might think that this image does appear to have black in certain parts, but those dark areas are made up using the combination of cyan, magenta, and yellow. The moment we add black, or the key color, so to speak, the image gets its depth. So, ideally, most of the color images that you see are made up of different tones of these four colors. They're called process colors. However, there can be spot colors added on top of these colors, like the metallic color or pastel color to achieve certain effects. Let me add a rectangle to the image to explain this. Let's go to the fill option and let's select blue as the color of the rectangle, and then right click and go to swatch options. In the pop-up menu, update the color type to spot. And from the color mode, let's change the color mode to Pantone Metallic Coated, which will further reveal a set of colors. These are different metallic shades of the Pantone Metallic Coated color, so let's pick one for our rectangle here. Now you can see in the separation, there is a fifth color added because it's a spot color or a special color that will be added to the image on top of the CMYK combination. Now you might think, can we not achieve this color using the combination of CMYK? Yes, you can to some extent, but it can only come close to this color, but not exactly the metallic shade that we get using the Pantone color. Try removing magenta, yellow, and black, and you can find that although cyan is closer to the Pantone color than the rest of the process colors, but the Pantone shade can still not be achieved using cyan alone. Alright, let's delete the rectangle. Now let's say we want to send this document to a printer. So ensure that when you send someone an InDesign file, you need to send all linked graphics and necessary fonts along with the project file. And to achieve that, you need to go to File and then select Package. In the dialog box that appears, the moment I click Package, it is going to ask me to save the document as I haven't saved it. Let's save it as Export and hit save. What we saved was the document, and now it's asking us to save the package. So I'm going to let the name be export folder and also ensure that the copy font, copy linked graphics, and update graphic links and package options are checked, and hit package. It might give you a warning that restrictions to copy fonts apply, so just hit OK. When you go to the package folder, you'll find it has the InDesign document, the PDF, the image, etc. So you can either send these documents separately to the printer, or the better way is to compress this folder into a zip format and then send it. Another thing to remember while working on a document is to set a pre-flight profile. So click here at the bottom panel and select Define Profiles. And in the dialog box, click the plus button at the bottom left to create a new pre-flight profile and give it a name. I'm going to name it InDesign Print. The reason why you should set a pre-flight profile is to ensure that while you edit your document, the pre-flight panel warns of problems that can prevent a document or book from printing or outputting as desired. These problems include missing files or fonts, low-resolution images, overset text, and a number of other conditions. So once your setting is complete, hit OK. Let me remind you that we've just created a pre-flight profile. We haven't applied it yet. To apply it, click the drop-down and select the profile we've just created. And as you can see, there are no errors showing, which means it's good to go. To export our document, we need to go to File and then Export. Rename it to any name of your choice should you want to, and pick the right format from here. Adobe PDF Print is used to share it with your clients or printer. PDF Interactive is used when you have interactive elements such as videos, sound clips, buttons, and page transitions. Export a document or book as a reflowable or fixed layout ebook that is compatible with the Adobe Digital Edition's reader software. Exporting to HTML is an easy way to get your InDesign contents into web-ready form. The InDesign markup or IDML format was introduced with InDesign CS4. A document stored in this variant can be opened across the entire version and improves compatibility when exchanging data. JPEG and PNG are compressed image formats in which JPEG does not support transparency, whereas PNG supports it. Lastly, XML or extensible markup language format can be viewed in a browser, an XML editing application, or text editor. So pick the right format and hit save, which will lead you to this screen. It's always better to use high quality print from the preset dropdown. Here you can choose the pages or spreads option that you'd like to print. Then move on to Marks and Bleeds tab and choose the necessary printer marks depending upon your requirement. I'm going to check crop marks and move on to Security tab. Here you can even add an extraction password, so once the PDF is created and sent to the relevant parties, and the moment they open it, it's going to prompt for a password that you can pass on to them through an email or otherwise, thereby securing the content within, and then hit export. Once the document is exported, you can locate it on the computer, double-click to open, and view it. You see, since we set the crop marks, you could find them here. So that's how you export your document in InDesign. Alright guys, that concludes our session today. I hope you've enjoyed it and have learned something new from it. So do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Until we meet again, goodbye and thanks for watching.